One of the Patrick Division semifinals, live on Sports Channel America.
Mike Richter, Don Gould, who's at practice today, and asked the coach.
Well, we're not announcing our goalkeeper
playoff rivalry. Now, that's not to say that it wasn't intense during this regular season. This always seemed to be flying when they got together. And remember back in October, even the coaches, Al Arbor and Roger Nielsen, wanted to get a piece of each other.
There's nothing to it. I mean, we just had a few words and that was over. We've known each other a long time.
Once in 12 years, you yell at a guy and you're considered enemies.
Sometimes it
was. NHL Patrick Division semifinal. Oh, yes, we know the Devils and Caps were getting it on just 12 miles away in the Meadowlands. But to the followers of the Rangers in the Isles, that game might as well have been on the moon. Let's go to Madison Square Garden to see what transpired. Rangers rely on old hockey adage, eliminate the other guy's big gun, like Pat LaFontaine. Chris Nyland nails him. Then Randy Muller nails him. The Rangers defy another hockey adage. Norman Rochefort tosses a stick, giving the Islanders Randy Wood a penalty shot. The rookie goalie, Mike Richter, supposed to be nervous. Wood gets advice from LaFontaine, goal scorer extraordinaire. He didn't listen. Richter with a kick save and a beauty. The left pad keeps the puck out of the net. Van Beesbrouck, the veteran on the bench, rooting him on. The Islanders, meanwhile, haunted by a young goalie, Mark Fitzpatrick, clears the puck out of the boards. But Chris Nyland collects it, hits Mark Jansen, who scores. It is 2-0 New York. Rangers, meanwhile, Richter was tremendous. Richter robbing Pat Flatley with a glove hand. Watch the save again. Roger Nielsen is relieved by the rookie goalie's play. Rangers lead it 2-1 late in the third period. Pat LaFontaine is belted by James Patrick. LaFontaine is out cold. It is a clean hit as we look at the replay. We'll see some not-so-clean hits later on. LaFontaine, we understand, taken to the hospital for x-rays. No word yet on any damage. He was removed on a stretcher. Then things got ugly. 2 seconds left in the game. It's been decided. The faceoff, as LaFontaine is wheeled out, the faceoff is in the Islanders' end. Ken Baumgartner, number 24, sucker punches Chris King. They ought to throw Baumgartner out of the playoffs. That's unbelievable. Then Mick Lakota goes at it with Nyland. The goalies even get into it, although there was no fighting. No players left the bench, but this was still an ugly incident, an embarrassment to an otherwise great game tonight at the Garden. The Rangers do win it by a score of 2-1, taking a one-game lead, and game two of the series will be at Madison Square Garden in New York City, and that will be on Saturday night. Now to that other game of the Meadowlands between the Devils and the Caps.
That ended last night's Islanders-Rangers game. The NHL had already announced a one-game suspension of Isles defenseman Ken Baumgartner, who started the melee with his attack on Chris King of the Rangers. Tonight, the NHL said that Isles goon Mick Vukota would be suspended 10 games without pay. He is out for the rest of the series. The Islanders, as a team, were fined $25,000. Isles coach Al Arbor fined $5,000 personally. Series resumes at the Garden tomorrow night. Rangers leading 1-0. Injured Islanders star Pat LaFontaine, released from the hospital today, is still questionable.
Garden, the Islanders and Rangers didn't drop the puck until 8:30 local time tonight. The Isles ringmaster Pat LaFontaine missed the game with a concussion courtesy of the Rangers, and that set the tone. 32 minutes of penalties in the first period alone. A wild second period at the Garden tonight with the Rangers up 2-1. Brad Lauer shoots. Mike Richter with a save, but Tom Fitzgerald is there to put the rebound home. The score is tied at 2. So Rangers after that on the power play. James Patrick's shot from the point sails by the screen. Mark Fitzpatrick, 3-2 Rangers. Moments later, off the faceoff, Kelly Kissio chips one to John Ogrodnik, and he beats Fitzpatrick for his second of the game, 4-2 Rangers. Then Fitzpatrick shows some frustration with Troy Millett on his back in the crease. He jams the butt of his stick into Millett's midsection, and he is gone from the game. Glenn Healy replaced him. But nothing could replace the scoring tonight. The Rangers go on to win it over the Islanders tonight to take a 2-0 lead in that series. 5-2 the final there. Betsy?
Finally over the line, takes a shot, trying to groove in around Norton, gets in deep, can't make the wraparound play. And McDonough can't clear the zone. There's Muller with a shot off the post. The rebound! They score!
Over the past decade, no New York sports rivalry has been more intense than the one existing between the Islanders and Rangers.
Morrow into the faceoff, and he scores! The Islanders will advance to the next round.
When these two fierce cross-town foes hit the ice around playoff time, it's nothing less than a New York sports classic. The tradition continues Saturday at 8:30 when the Islanders battle the Rangers in game two of the Pac-12.
Mullen dumping it in from center. The Rangers turn to go for a player change. Fitzpatrick, Rache turned it over, and they score! Jansen! over the Ranger line. Trache moves in to pick up the puck. Fires one. He scores! Brian Trache brings the Islanders two teams. And tonight, we're going to go back to 1979. After sweeping Chicago in four straight in the preliminary round, they faced the Rangers. The Islanders did in a semifinal, a team they'd beaten five times in the regular season. The Rangers had already swept the Kings and eliminated the Flyers in five. And in the nets, a 26-year-old by the name of John Arthur Davidson. Brilliant, as the Rangers beat the Islanders in six games. They won 4-1. And lost 4-3 in overtime at the Nassau Coliseum. Then came back and won 3-1 here. The series was tied going back to the Nassau Coliseum. They won there and then won here thanks to the goaltending of John Davidson. By that time, wearing number 30 and now wearing a colleague's outfit and joins us here tonight. J.D., your memories, your thoughts, and remembrances of 79.
Jakes, it was a lot of fun in those days. I think the post-series memories have to revolve around the friendships that we made after with Denny Putvin and Eddie Westfall and people like Bobby Nystrom. But during the series, it was a real intense battle. It was the first time as a Ranger that I was able to finally find out what the Ranger-Islander rivalry was all about in this immense city, and to see people that basically weren't hockey fans become involved, and to see a city that was this large where everyone became involved, it was a great experience for me.
Not to embarrass you at all, but is it true that Westfall really scored on you on a backhand?
Yes, he did. And after he scored on a backhand shot one night in the Coliseum, and the shot was from the blue line, it was my fault for going in. It took about 6 minutes before I got pulled, and I couldn't figure out why. Is because that's how long it took for John Ferguson, our general manager, to leave the press box, get down to the bench to tell Jean-Guy Talbot to get me out of there. It was an embarrassing moment.
Then, of course, the Rangers went on to face the Montreal Canadiens in the Stanley Cup Final. An injury problem there.
Yeah, actually, I injured my knee during the Islander series. I believe it was game five, back out on the island. And it was sore, and it's something that required surgery during the offseason. We made a pretty good run. We were not the better team in the finals. Montreal was. They had some great power with Lafleur and Lemaire and a great guy that won the Conn Smythe that year, and Bob Gainey. But it was an experience for all of us, and seeing young Don Maloney go out and play it. He was a rookie that year, by the way, and he set a record along with Phil Esposito for most points in a playoff round with the Rangers. Great to see him doing so well now.
In one word, how does this team compare, this team of 90 to 79?
Rangers. Our team was a surprise. The team this year has a lot more balance, more real scoring up front. And you know something, in all sincerity, right now they have a better goaltender, Richter.
Tonight at 5-2. The New York Islanders return home for game three of this division series up next on Sports Channel.
A 3-1 lead into the third period. Flatley scored on a power play at 11:47, and then Hubie McDonough tied it.
The Rangers had the puck kept in the zone, and McDonough took three different shots at the puck and finally chipped it up over top of John Van Beesbrouck, and he celebrates, and so he should. That tied the game at three.
In the final seconds, a mad scramble here, John.
Well, you just watch Moeller's stick. Number 24 for the Rangers chipped the puck right there. Oh. And look who was coming in. Lauer had John Van Beesbrouck down. If Moeller doesn't get to the puck, Lauer would have, and perhaps we wouldn't have had overtime.
And
a shot, 3-2 Rangers. Moments later, Islanders will tie it up. A minute 22 later, Hubie McDonough lifts in the rebound off a Gary Nyland shot. This game is tied up at three apiece as they hit into overtime at the Nassau Coliseum. Well, Dennis, these two teams going into overtime now, what is it like for the players? What do they do in OT?
They will be reminded, Bob, by the coaches that in OT, you reduce the game to shifts, one shift at a time. You're going to keep the puck ahead of you, and you're going to shoot whenever you get a chance. Most goals in OT come from scrambles in front of the nets and rebounds. You can bet that they're going to dump the puck in and work hard. Defensive game cannot be forgotten because you're willing to play as long as it takes to win.
And that game is
at three apiece, and the Islanders sent the game to overtime. Prior to that, before McDonough, the Islanders, I should say after McDonough, with the score tied 3-3, this laser beam by Gerald Diddick. There's one post. There's the second goal post, and the puck went all the way down the ice.
And now overtime is underway. The Islanders controlling the puck. Jeff Dorton turned back by the assistant. Flatley over the line. Center with a shot that just missed the post on the far side.
all the way down into the Islanders' zone. Bonick streaking down right wing. Puts his head down to sneak in around the check and throws for it. Bonick from back of the net, trying to make the play in front to Sutter, and he got double teamed. Ranger down at the dead end. His shot is
goal of the playoffs. Montreal, a 2-1 winner in overtime. They lead the series 2-1. Back to Jiggs McDonald and Eddie Westfall.
At
better. As a defenseman, you often realize that there are going to be times in the game where you're going to be put in a position that you don't really want to be in, and that position is no man's land. That is found when the defenseman is being harassed, as he is here by Chris Nyland. 2 feet from the boards, you get hit from the back. It's hard to make that a call, like a five-minute call. But the fact is that Jeff Norton is injured and injured badly. We certainly hope that he will recover quickly. But the no man's land is a zone that every defenseman is aware of. And in time, you tend to develop a sixth sense just for the
shot. The Islanders in this passion play with a puck led by the Rangers coming in tonight. 2-0. First period, Islander power play. Jeff Norton to Brett Sutter. He scores 1-0 Isles. Later in the first period, Troy Millett pulls the trigger, ties the game at one apiece. Glenn Healy, spectacular night. Stops Ogrodnik in front and covers it up. Randy Wood skating in. And this time, it caroms off the post and wide. Ranger 5-on-3 advantage. James Patrick walks in and puts it in. Rangers up 2-1. A 5-on-4 power play. Bernie Nichols between the legs of Healy. 3-1 Rangers. 2 goals in 80 seconds. Al Arbor, 10 minutes to go. You're down a couple of goals. Brent Sutter slap shot deflected in by Pat Flatley. And the lead is down to 1 goal. Ben Beesbrook with a great save here. But Hume McDonough with the rebound. Puts it past Beezer. Overtime we go. Tied at 3. Now with 8 seconds to go in the first OT. Norton is Jeff Norton. Stick by Chris Nyland. And check by Troy Millett with 8 seconds. He suffers a concussion. It is a 5-minute major for boarding. Of course, the power play into the second OT. The feed to Brent Sutter, and there's the winning goal, 59 seconds into the second overtime. The longest OT for the Rangers since they went into a third OT against the Chicago Blackhawks back in 71. So the Isles get on the board in the series. And yes, it's been rough, it's been tough, and we'll see what carries over into game four from that concussion given to Jeff Norton. 4-3.
Waiting on that. What can I say? We won the hockey game, and that's first and foremost.
It's nice to win in playoffs, and especially in front of your home fans. You know, they were so charged up tonight. They wanted a good performance, and we gave it to them.
It certainly puts a different cast in the whole affair now. I mean, we were down 3-1 in the middle of the third. Looked pretty bleak, but that seems to be the way it's been all season. So we fought back and got our win, and we're back in the series now.
With one rally and one of those classic Islander overtime goals, the 1990 edition of this rivalry just became legitimate. Don Gould, News 4 at the Nassau Coliseum.
Game 4 tomorrow night on the Island of the Devil.
Number 44, Lindy Ruff gets trapped behind the play. Here come the Islanders. Rob DeMille, he sees he's in a good spot, and he rips a hard shot into the top right-hand corner. Laxdal, what a job on containing Lindy Ruff. That allows DeMille to break away. It's a 2-on-1 break, and he
will go ahead. 29 seconds later, Rob DeMille, just called up from Springfield, gives the Islanders a 2-1 lead, but the Rangers tie it on a power play goal. Kelly Kissio flips it toward the net. John Ogrodnik deflects it in past Mark Fitzpatrick. 2-2 the score at the end of the first period. Dennis Potvin. Pat LaFontaine back, he's added so much to the team already.
It's really unbelievable. It's a totally different hockey team. We mentioned earlier in the broadcast that Trache, King, and Kerr were going to be scratched simply because probably speed, a little bit of age, and not really a lot of good chemistry at the moment. Boy, LaFontaine and the new young players are adding so much speed. It's a different hockey team, and it's really causing some problems for the Rangers tonight.
All right.
Period, the Rangers held a slim 5-4 lead, but a burst from Gartner soon sealed the deal.
Sends Gartner over the Islander line. Big slap shot, he scores! Gartner with his first ever Stanley Cup playoff hat trick.
Gartner's final tally made the score 6-4, and though the Islanders later managed to pull within a goal, they would go no further.
Into Flatley, centers, it's broken up, goes off Bonick. The Rangers have won it in 5 games.
And for just the second time in 7 meetings, the Rangers had ousted the Islanders from the playoffs. It was a tough but convincing win.
Our club showed a lot of grit. They didn't quit. They kept on fighting and fighting, and like I say, the